utilizes silicon solar cells instead of gallium arsenide solar cells. That was a race regulation that we had to conform to. We're in the process right now of designing Rot 8, and we have to design a completely new car for the races coming up because they changed the design regulations such that we can't modify this car in order to fit them. You kind of saw how Kaylee was in the car. And if you look under the car right now, the driver's feet are actually above their butt. And you shouldn't say butt when you're talking to third graders, I found out. Because immediately it goes there. So, but I can say it to you because we're all, you know. But her legs were above her butt, which allowed us to package the driver in a really nice way. But the new regulations are actually saying that your ankles have to be the lowest point of your body. Oh. So if we were to try and modify this car in order to meet that regulation, you'd have to grow the bottom of the car where the driver's legs are, and there's just too many changes. The other big change that's requiring us to build a whole new car is the World Solar Challenge, which is one of the races we do, is requiring 4 wheels. This is a 3-wheeled car, so that's another design consideration.
And that World Solar Challenge is in Australia.
Yeah.
Goes right through the whole continent from Darwin down to Adelaide. We've done it 3 times before.
This entire car weighs about 400 pounds without the driver. We can go down the road at 55 miles an hour on roughly 1,100 watts, so less than a hair dryer, a normal hair dryer. We can go 55 miles an hour down the road. This last race,
We should put the design in the car.
this last race in the U.S. was 8 days, and it went through 8 states. Started in New York, and went kind of through Ohio, Michigan, Indiana, Illinois, Wisconsin, and ended in Minneapolis, St. Paul. It was 8 days, 8 states, and Raw 7S finished third. We finished third behind the University of Michigan. University of Michigan has a budget of about $2.5 million per car, and quite a few more engineers than Principia College has.
We have none.
Well, you think of it. The University of Michigan, anybody go to the University of Michigan? I always have to ask that. Their graduate mechanical engineering department is larger than our entire college. But we have just shy of 500 students at our college. And the second place team was Iowa State, and then Principia College, and coming in behind us, maybe you've heard of them, like MIT, Minnesota,
Berkeley, like Stanford, Berkeley,
schools like that. So, you know, little known schools. The race, 8 days, three of the days there was no sun, complete downpour rain, and most of the cars had to crawl to, you know, 10 to 20 miles an hour during those kinds of conditions. Raw 7S, because of the work we were able to do and achieve using the NX package, and, you know, being able to go down the road very efficiently, we were doing about 40 to 45 during, you know, the torrential downpour with no sun. And we were able to conserve enough energy because of all the other things that we had achieved using the software. So 3 days were like that. 3 days were 110 degree heat, which we had never seen in a race before. So it was a very grueling race. I've been involved in the project since the late 90s, Steve a little bit before myself, and I don't think I've ever seen conditions in a race that swung from no sun to torrential downpour to sun and, you know, crazy heat. Some of the questions that we always get asked: how fast does it go? The motor is a 12 horsepower DC brushless motor. And we can go roughly, I mean, the motor is rated to 95 miles an hour. We've personally raced Principia College at over 75 miles an hour, or 85, sorry, over 85 miles an hour. So how fast does it go? Does it get hot? I can let Kaylee answer that question.
Nah.
Typically, what we've said in the past is it's about 10 degrees above ambient. And that really, you know, it shifts. It depends on if you're stopped at a red light, if you're moving. As you can tell, it's a black car. It's kind of a big heat sink. Our next one might be white. The driver does have a little bit of reprieve right under the American flag.
Yeah,
it's kind of a little scoop.
And, that's the AC.
That's the AC. We always joke that the AC is really the driver has a bag of water. We tell them to take a sip, spit it on themselves, and let the air, you know, go over the water. The problem is when it's 110 degrees, that doesn't work so well. And then you always have the problem of Kaylee's really short. Our other driver was about 6 foot, 6'1", and their heads are at different positions. And you know, in order to change where that scoop goes, we actually used a piece of little cardboard and some tape. I know it's really advanced.